Hey. I'd like to welcome everyone to another Morning Glory Apostolic Prophetic Center video. I'm your host, Dedrick Hubbard. And today we're going to be in 1 Corinthians chapter 9. And today's topic is let's read the charges. And many of you got to understand, when you're in ministry, there are always going to be naysayers, fault finders. They're going to be judgmental people. And sometimes it's not only your friends, family, and people that you don't know. You give them some, it's often sometimes people that you're in ministry with. So when we talk about let's read the charges, you know, a lot of you are getting ready to start ministry in some form or fashion. It may be live streaming like me. It may be in person. It may be a podcast. It may be street preaching. But whatever it is, if God leading you to do it, do it. But I just want y'all to know, opposition gonna come. And more often than ever, opposition comes in your own home, in your family, in your friends, and sometimes even on your job. And a lot of times, and it's sad to say, in your own family. That's why the Bible tells you a prophet without is not without honor in his own home. So when you call in the ministry, you can it can immediately accept that nobody that grew up with you and know you gonna know you. If you get married or dating, and if they are not in God, they're not going to know you. So when we talk about let's read the charges, I was sitting here and God was showing me things that I've been going through lately. And most of it from close friends, family, and, you know, even I ain't got no house now. So y'all know about that there. So I can't say it, but I just say around the family. People are, you know what I'm saying? It's the ridicule that you get from people who's supposed to have your back, who say they love you, who say they support you, who say they understand you, who say no matter what, I'm going to go with you. So God was sitting here. He said, what I want you to do today, he said, I want you to teach people how to vindicate their ministry. Vindicate their ministry is when you got opposition coming against you. By the time I get through with this, you'll understand what you got to do. So when we say, let's read the charges, these are the charges that people often give me, accuse me of. So we're going to be in 1 Corinthians chapter 9, because just like Paul did all this work. Paul did everything God telling him. Paul was flowing in the Holy Spirit. But even then, it was always people around that doubted and judged Paul. So just like Paul, every now and then, you got to let a nigga know you ain't nothing to play with. If you don't like that language in life, because sometimes you get fed up trying to do right by God, and these niggas come behind you fault finding. You do this, you do that, you do that, you do this, you that. Go to hell. That's the way I feel about it. But I can't say that. So he said, read the charges. And when I read these charges, y'all just understand, when you line your life up, how I line my life up, whatever they say against you, it shouldn't worry you. It shouldn't bother you. And it shouldn't mess with nothing you do. But every now and then, you ain't nothing to play with. 1 Corinthians chapter 9. It says, am I not an apostle? Am I not free? Have I not seen Jesus Christ our Lord? Are not ye my work in the Lord? So watch this. The first charge I got against me is my calling. People doubt who I am. The only people who can doubt who I am is because they ain't seen Jesus Christ. Because when I talk about seeing Jesus Christ, that means really want Christ. All right. So first thing he Paul say, am I not apostle? Which means when you become confident in your call, that's your call. I don't care if people gonna call you fake. I don't care if you call you false. I don't care if they call you bootleg. As long as you know your call, walk in your call. Am I not free? What does that mean? I don't care about doctrine. I don't care about religion. I don't care about convocation. I don't care what you think. I don't care whatever false revelation you give me. All I know is Christ. That's all I know. And in knowing Christ, that's what makes me free. See, watch this. I ain't got to call the pastor and say, Pastor, can you pray for me? I ain't got to be sitting around there talking about I got to pay my tithes or God ain't going to bless me. I know the truth about stuff like that. I ain't got to sit around there and say, I got to make sure I have this covering over here. I ain't got to do that. Have I not seen Jesus Christ, our Lord? The only way, if you see Jesus Christ, is that God draw you. It's in the Bible. And when God draw you to begin to see Jesus, the only way you know Jesus is you got a heart like Jesus got. You think like Jesus got. You operate like Jesus, right? Why? Because are ye not my work and my Lord? Which means my calling. A lot of you, stop proving yourself. If you call me false, okay. If you say I'm bootleg, okay. If you stay on my lip, okay. God is the only proof I need. Why is that? Are not ye my working the Lord? See, watch this. If I've been in ministry approximately over 15 years now, I can count on my hand how many people, they didn't come to God. Watch this now. They didn't come to God under me. They didn't learn the Bible over me. When people come to me, this is how you got to know who you are in God. When people come to me, they either leave in church or they want to know their gifts. That's all I get, which means I know my lane. That's why if you hear any of my messages, wherever you find, I got some old one on something called Ustream, Blog Talk Radio. If you hear any of my messages from my conception, it'll still be basically the same. Might be the same scripture, different revelation, but it's the same, which means what? I know my lane. I know why people come to me. See, watch this. So when you say, can I join your church? I ain't no church. They let me know you ain't in Christ. You get what I'm saying? So watch this. So for a person to sit around and constantly ridicule who I am in God, to constantly say, you ain't doing this, to constantly say, well, you say this, but you do that. That's a person that's not connected to Christ. Because if you see my work in the Lord, I can honestly say who I help. They can honestly say, Brother Hubbard, help me. So now, with the charge of talking about my calling, that's a false charge. I can't let you charge me with a felony for my calling. Because I can prove you wrong. So why you still want to doubt who I am? The only reason people doubt, convict, ridicule, and judge who you are, because they in secret competition with you. They actually want to be with you, but to be like we are and some of us coming to be, you got to let some stuff go. You got to let some go. You know what I'm saying? See, the reason y'all can't get where we at because you can't renounce worldly things. Listen here. God ain't going to ask you, are you a Freemason to get into heaven? He gonna show you how Freemasonry has nothing to do with God, but it got God's word in it. God ain't gonna ask you, are you an AKA or a Q-Law? But he gonna show you where the error at in it, even though they use God. Well, how you know that, Brother Hubbard? Verse 2. If I be not an apostle to others, yet doubtless I am to you. For the seal of my apostleship are ye in the Lord, because I'm telling you what God has shown me and told me. That's why I speak like I speak about what I speak. The only ones that don't could be convicted about what I speak, especially when I'm talking about them sorority fraternity, is because your identity in it. See, that's why, don't y'all know why I tell y'all, who are you outside of what you connected to? See, if you can't be you outside of connected and listen to me, then I'm your identity. Which means you can't leave me alone because your identity in me. But watch this. That's why I teach most of y'all to learn who you is yourself. Why? Because Brother Hubbard got to leave him. And when I leave him, you got to stand on your own. See, they can't leave them for the Masons and Eastern Stars, all those Ferrari and Serrano, because that's their identity. They won't leave them for nothing. But watch this. Let them get in trouble and watch how fast they drop them. You know somebody who ain't going to drop me when I get in trouble? God. Get in trouble with them. Don't watch this. Don't follow their laws and watch how they deal with you. But when I mess up and don't follow God's law, he got something about grace and mercy. Huh? So next thing we got to understand, the jury. When you facing charges, they teach you got to have a jury of your peers. All right. So if Paul, watch this. So if I be not apostle unto you, doubtless I am to you, for the seal of my apostleship are ye in the Lord. So watch this. You want to doubt who I am, but ain't got no proof of who you are. You want to say that I don't hear God and God don't work in me, but you ain't got no proof that God in you. So when Paul goes on and still defending his ministry, he said, you my seal. What does that mean? When I pick my jury, I'm going to be just like Dr. Sebi. Them people in the world took Dr. Sebi to court because they said whatever he said he cured AIDS and all that, they said that's not true. So the medical people took him to court. But guess who won? Dr. Sebi. Why did he win? Because the people that he treated after they gave up with what the world medicine did, found out by Dr. Sebi, they had the same medical reports that their doctors had, but then they had the treatment of what Dr. Sebi had. And he cured them. So he won. See, watch this. If you're going to constantly convict me, please have some proof of who you are. If watch this. Because they always watching my videos, plenty of them. If I'm teaching this and you see me doing something contrary to what I'm doing, look at your life. What are you doing that's contrary to the word of God? Judge not, lest you be judged. The Bible says we all fall short of the glory of God. As long as I've been preaching, if y'all don't hear it all the time, you hear it often. I tell you, I ain't the perfect leader, but I hear God. Why do God continue to lead me? Because he know I'm going to be truthful about things that he needs you to know the truth about. Even up to telling you things that I do. I tell people I get mad. When I was in the house, when I get mad at my wife, or for some reason, I tell you I got mad at her for no reason. Why? Because we still flesh. And for flesh to, watch this, for flesh to judge flesh lets me know you ain't got no spirit. Ooh, this good. Ain't this good? God talking, I know it's good. So I got a jury of my peers because I can show my work in the Lord. I can show you the ministries I built. I can show you the people that I didn't help. I didn't show you the people I got delivered. What do you have that you can show that God, Jesus, or the Holy Spirit, whichever one you want to use, is really in you? Now we got to look at the evidence. That's verse 3. Y'all notice how I'm going verse to verse. Why? Because sometimes when you got to tell a nigga off, they like to call you to the carpet. They like to have a list of your flaws. They like to have a list of a condemnation towards you. So sometimes you got to go step by step and let them know, I'm not no fool by no means. You got to let them know. It said, my answer to them that do examine me is this. What's your evidence at? See, a lot of them are faulty prosecutions. Because see, they'll call somebody on the phone or they'll go in secret and tell everybody about what you did. But when it comes to them, they leave some out. See, but watch this. Watch the mentality of a fool. Or they'll say, I did this because you made me do this. Can't nobody make you do nothing. You do it when you make up your mind to do it. Well, watch this. So if I had a girlfriend, let's say, and I ain't like her no more, I tell her to go on. And she go immediately go mess with another man. But then I have a change of heart and tell her I want her back. But then I see her messing with the other man. I don't want her no more. You made me do this. See, watch this. Watch people action. This is how you examine people. When a person leave your life, or when a person do something to you that you seem hurtful, rejected, or abandoned, when you run to things of the world, watch this. When you run to the things of the world, after that person is gone, that's what you want to do anyway. See, it's just like a couple that get divorced or a couple that's going through something. Well, see, let's take me for instance. If me and my wife into it like we is now, she don't see what I'm saying, I don't see what I'm saying, I ain't running to other women. I ain't running this and that. I'm running to God. I'm in fasting and praying because he's showing me what the issue is. Huh? I ain't running to the nearest party. Watch this. I put everything on hold that pertains to my life, but guess what still has to stay open? Everything God want me to do. Everything God want me to do. So watch this. If you break up with your boyfriend, you find him at the club with somebody else, when they're now. Because when you break up with something or something happen with something that means something to you, you go to God. You go to God for a solution. You don't go to these so-called friends, family, especially if you ain't going to tell the truth. The Bible says tell the truth. Let somebody come to me. I'm telling the truth. See, watch that. I can't help but tell the truth because I'm a minister of the gospel, so I got to say the truth. So watch this. You fault finders, you jealous people, that's why you ain't got no authority. So you look for evidence every chance you get to condemn me, to go against me, to make me look bad. Because secretly, you wish that you could have what God done gave me. Oh, of course they're going to say no. But that's what jealous people do. Because they're trying to find a shortcut. Verse 4. Have we not power to eat and to drink? So here Paul goes in talking about power. And what he's actually doing is talking about decisions. See, Paul was getting into that. See, I ain't tell y'all. So actually this scripture is really about the church wanting Paul to get something from them, and Paul didn't want it. So they perceived Paul wasn't of God because Paul didn't act like everybody else had acted with them. See, that's just like me. When I'm called to go out to preach a visit, I don't look for no money. But everybody before me look for money. So then when I come, they assume I want their money. I done been to places and they done offer me thousands, sometimes hundred. I said, I don't want it. I don't want it. They say, you sure? I said, yeah, sew it back in the church. But when I get home, I got people that was in the service. Hey, what I had to give, I didn't have enough. So God told me to let you know what I'm finna give. I'm gonna send it to you through PayPal. Watch this. It was more, sometimes it was more than what they took up in the offer. It was more. It was enough for my hotels. Either way, because I used to wear a Greyhound or I fly the plane. I used to eat. People had to come pick me up. And some in my pocket. That's why I always been known as the fee-free preacher, because when I got started in the ministry, that's what God told me to say. He said, you don't need nothing. I'm going to provide for you. So this is basically what 2 Corinthians chapter 9 is about. Paul wasn't acting like everybody else. You get what I'm saying? So when he talk about have we not power to eat and to drink, what he's saying, if I got to turn something down that you offering me, I'm going to turn it down. Not because I may not want to turn it down, but because God may tell me you don't need it. And see, for a lot of times, people are sending me some, I send it back. Because when you sending stuff to me, especially when it relates to money, I automatically receive the spirit in which the money is given. I can tell if somebody trying to buy me, somebody trying to. I can just tell when it ain't given with the full spirit of God. I know it. Let's just put it like that. All right. Verse 5 says, have we not power to lead about a sister, a wife, as well as other apostles, and as brother of the Lord, and Cephas? See, watch this. I got leadership. The leadership God gave me, I could be a leader in any format. Because I'm leading by his spirit. So here was Paul was saying, let's get some examples of the authority that you say you got. You know, how many people are you leading to Christ? Or are you leading them to the bedroom? Are you leading? See, how you gonna say, how you gonna say you're a child of God and you leading people to the nearest party, to the nearest watering hole so y'all can get y'all drinks? When are you speaking about God? Huh? And that's what's wrong with a lot of people. You got a relationship with church, but you don't have a relationship with God. Watch this, six. Or I only and Barnabas have not we power to forbear working. And see, the next charge they gave me was about money. You know, people be on Facebook and they ain't nobody, they think they be throwing shots. But you know, I read stuff clear. I know about subliminals. I got the Holy Spirit. I ain't never took no money from nobody. Ain't nobody never had to do this. Ain't nobody had nothing to do that. So what happened is they was concerned that they didn't have no money, but they wouldn't take the money that they was giving them. Which means Paul said, okay, I ain't really got to take your money and I ain't got no job because I depend on God to take care of me. See, and that's what's missing. That's a key point that Paul actually mentioned that's omitted. See, we'll give and say it for the kingdom, But you don't give and say, is it for the one that working in the kingdom? Verse 7 says, "What?" And this going to teach him. Who goeth at warfare at any time at his own charges? Who planted a vineyard and eateth not of the fruit thereof? Or who feedeth a flock and eateth not of the milk of the flock? So basically what Paul was saying here, I'm doing ministry. Okay? So if I'm doing ministry, which means is if I'm seeing the demons, if I'm seeing the attack, if I'm seeing the person who God wants you to be, what a lot of you don't know about ministry because your leaders never teach you, and that's why I'm teaching this too. Ministry is not easy. At any given time, I probably got to pray for over 50 or 60 people. At any given time, I'm constantly in contact with probably 10 or 15 different people. At any given time, I got to hear what God got to say and what he want me to preach. I got to watch out for my environment. I got to pray for my house and my family. So watch this. That's what it's talking about. You shouldn't have to beg for support from people you build it. So I take that back. Somebody sent me some money the other day and they said, I think this for you. And then when they sent it, they say it's for you. It's for you. See what Paul was saying, why give to the kingdom and thinking I need it and saying it's for the kingdom, but then you forget about the individual that's helping you to get in the kingdom. Because the kingdom is already established. It just needs the people to work it. That's what we are. We the people that say, hey, God calling you to do this. Why you think I send emails out every now and then, hey, you need to watch this, but you can do this. I had one inbox me late one night talking about, he was telling me about this spirit that has came in. And I said, did you check the north gate? See, that's that deep stuff. When you know about them gates and which side it is, that's a whole nother realm of teaching. And I said, I believe it coming from this side because this is what it represents. I don't just know that. You got to hear the spirit of God. So verse 8, he says, say I these things as a man, or said not the law the same also. So basically that was a law. And what we understand in verse 9, he repeats the law. He says, for it is written in the law of Moses, thou shalt not muzzle the mouth of the ox that treadeth out the corn. Did God take care for the oxen? That means, so in them times, they used to put this thing on the ox, and the ox used to walk around while they knocking the stuff down. But if the ox got hungry, if you had a muzzle on the ox mouth as he treading at the corn is falling down, you won't take the time. If you got the muzzle on the ox can't eat the corn that's falling if the ox get hungry. What does an ox do when it get hungry? Which means he resting and eating. See, sometimes we got to rest. Sometimes we got to eat. Sometimes I want to go out. So when you got people that you know dedicating their life to you for ministry, then God saying, hey, you can take care of them. And see, this is what the whole fight about, that Paul wouldn't receive the money. The reason Paul probably didn't receive the money is basically what I'm telling you. Why give me something that's connected to God and is not connected to me? What do I mean by that? It means if everything I get go through the kingdom, then okay, I can't take from the kingdom unless God say so. But suppose God just want to know, let me show you who know you. That's like somebody, a friend I know, he used to keep his money and his wife stole it. All right. But when they stole it, because they don't understand the spirit of it, from what I gather, all the money was together and they stole it. But watch this. How God gonna tell you what something is and you stealing what you get? That wasn't God. That's flesh. That was pride. That was emotion. So I told him, I said, don't worry about it. The time gonna come that she got to pay. See, y'all got to watch how y'all handle people who you know without a shadow of doubt that they hear God. You just can't lie on me and think you're gonna get away with it. Because if you tarnish my image, you mess up my character. If you mess up my character, then you mess up the people that I had already built up. And you mess up the people that I had built up, then God is anger, is kindled on that person who tries their best to look people like us look bad, and y'all know we winning. We winning. Because when you come around to me, if you want the truth, I'm going to snatch you out of the darkness. I'm going to give you some light. But when you half in and you half out, you're going to always go toward the darkness because it's in the darkness where you find your identity. My identity ain't in no darkness. So what God told me, your faith is non-negotiable in this city. I refuse to go to some club, somebody shake their ass. I refuse to go to somebody's party just so they can smoke weed, get high, and tell a lie. I refuse. Because my relationship from where I came from and my relationship with God is more important than anybody's feelings, what they think, the lies they tell. So I'll be the villain. I'll be the enemy. Because one thing about God, he said, vengeance is mine, said the Lord. I ain't got to get you back. But I got somebody who know how to get you back. And see, for many of people, if you look in your circle, the reason they going through is because they was trying to kill you. They trying to kill your character. They trying to kill your ministry. They trying to kill your spirit. And God is in the judgment. It's the judgment season. Verse 10 says, or say he it altogether for our sakes. For our sakes, no doubt that this is written, that he that ploweth shall plow in hope, and that he that thresheth in hope shall be partake of his hope. If we have sown unto you spiritual thing, it is a great thing if we shall reap your carnal thing. If others be partaker of this power over you, are not we rather? Nevertheless, we have not used this power, but suffer all things, lest we shall hinder the gospel of Christ. So what Paul was saying, man, I love to get money. I love to help people. But watch this. If I use that power because I know I got it, then watch this. I hinder the gospel of Christ. How do I hinder the gospel of Christ? Like these prophets be doing. You get in this $100 healing line. Suppose somebody need healing and ain't got no $100. You hinder the gospel. Suppose if everything I do, I charge for it and people needed me. And I say, you got to give me $2,000. And they ain't got it. That's hindering the gospel. So watch this. Why you think most of the people that connected to me, for the people to say he just be getting that money? I don't just get nobody money. For many of them, they said, God told me to give you this. For many of you, God said, this is my covenant of what I give you. See, I don't have to put up this is my PayPal for all y'all who asking. This is my PayPal information. Don't be no all y'all. It'll be one or two people, but they just want to make sure anybody want to give can give. See, a lot of people got to understand. They done made ministry about money, and if they can't get money in ministry, they don't believe it's ministry. So watch this. So how many times have anybody ever seen me go without? Because I never say nothing. If others be to all, but suffer all things. Listen here. Although it looks like I live a nice life, it's a nice life. But like some of y'all, certain things I worry about if I don't have enough for. Now I'm going to pay that rent if I don't do nothing else. Because what? If I want to sit in the dog, at least I can sit in the dog in my house. But I got to, but if I'm living in my truck, I got to live in my truck. So watch this. Don't put, see, and see, that's why a lot of leaders suffer in silence, because when you really connected to somebody, hey, let me send this over to Brother Hubbard. He just might need something today. Verse 13 said, do ye not know that they that which minister about holy things live of the things of the temple, and they which wait at the altar are partakers with the altar? Even so have the Lord ordained that they which preach this gospel shall live of the gospel. So how can I tell y'all stuff that go on in heaven if I ain't never been to heaven or never had these visions or tell you these revelations if the Holy Spirit don't give it to me? So watch this. You got people that use scripture with no revelation. You get what I'm saying? And so, especially like today, somebody came at me talking about that scripture, marriage being undefiled. What does undefiled mean? What does undefiled mean? The word. See the church said undefiled means anything go in the bedroom, because they damn dumb. I'm just gonna say it like that. But if you look at in the dictionary and see what undefiled mean, it says not made corrupt, impure, or unclean. That's what it means, undefiled. Watch this. So if God didn't call sodomy perversion, guess what? If God don't accept it, how he gonna twist the scripture but the marriage being undefiled? God ain't gonna change his Bible just because you wanna suck some cock, eat some cooch. Y'all dumb. Undefiled means not made corrupt. So when you suck that cock, you cock Thoris, and what they call you do your double whack 4,000. Watch this. I ain't got no heaven or hell to put you in. I don't care what you do in the bedroom. But watch this. If I don't tell you that it ain't wrong, it is what, that doesn't make me a hypocrite. That don't make me a bastard. Watch this. In order for me not to be a castaway, I got to preach the whole Bible. Go to one of them 60 churches and see how many of them read that scripture, man should not lay with man. See, the problem is a lot of people script over the scripture and so they can't be convicted about what they doing. Huh? So if Brother Hubbard did want some, guess what? Don't preach this gospel that is in there, because we flesh too. You know how many people I see on TikTok making excuses with that word undefiled? Undefiled means not made corrupt, impure, unclean. So if God calls sodomy unclean, it's unclean, which means you don't introduce it into the bed word in the bedroom, you dumbest. Dumb, da dum dum. And y'all got all these theology, but watch this. If that's what you like, that's what you like. I don't know if you're going to heaven or hell for doing it. That ain't my place. You know why it ain't my place? Because the Bible said, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. So why are you worrying about what I do right or wrong? But and this my salvation. So if you want to be a throat goat, if you want to be a coptologist, if you want to be a cunnilingus specialist, that's your goddamn business. It ain't mine. Do what you want to do. I don't care if they knock a hole in the back of your neck and his tongue touch a tonsil and play drums on it. That's y'all business. But I'm going to preach it if it's in his word. Because I ain't finna preach nothing that ain't in here and I get held accountable. Yeah, you were doing that. You like a little head yourself, so you won't preach about it. See, that's what most people do. They stay away from it, or they transfer the word to make it feel better. Don't come at me with no scripture like that and you ain't got no revelation. Yeah, a bad B-I-T-C-H. That's all they want to be. Watch this. Well, man. Verse 15, but I have used none of these things, neither have I written these things that it should be so done unto me. For it were better for me to die than that any man should make my glory in void. For though I preach the gospel, I have nothing to glory of. For necessity is laid upon me. Woe is unto me if I preach not the gospel. For if I do this thing willingly, I have a reward. But if against my will, a dispensation of the gospel is committed unto me. See, God had called a lot of y'all to ministry, but you waiting on somebody else to set you up in ministry. Do you know I often get accused? I try to hold people back. I've been in this for 15 years. I don't hold nobody back. Matter of fact, I try to rush you to go forward, but I can't rush you to go forward because you only go forward when you come. I'm not a holder back of people. So necessity is made that I do this. See, some of y'all can only do it when you got a crowd. When you got to go viral. Do you know when I turn this on, every video I make go viral? Because those legions of angels sitting there, that dumb brother Hubbard show giving today, I'm already viral. I'm not a viral to according to man's standards, so I don't get no TikTok check and no YouTube check. But watch this. For if I do this thing willingly, I have a reward. My reward in heaven. So every time I go live, I go viral. And ain't no telling how many rewards I got up there. You don't never see Brother Hubbard make this go viral. Y'all make this go viral. I don't need to go viral. Because Christ left the 99 to go to the one. So all I need is one person to listen to whatever I'm saying at the right time. And guess what? It's done. Verse 19. For though I be free from all men, yet have I made myself a servant unto all that I might gain the more. And unto the Jews, I became as a Jew, that I might gain the Jew. To them that are under the law, as under the law, that I might gain them that are under the law. To them that are without law, as without law, being not without law to God, but under the law to Christ, that I might gain them that are without law. See, watch this. That's why I don't mind when people call me worldly. I say worldly things sometimes to get worldly people attention. And if I get worldly people attention with worldly things, when I preach that real gospel, I got them. Huh? I got to become all things. I got to be a shapeshifter. Watch this. If I have to act gay to get a gay person to come to Christ, guess what I'm going to say? Hey, honey, come here. And then when I get them by themselves, pounce that gospel on them. Huh? If I got to go on the corner and play like a John to get a prostitute, hey, baby, come here. They're gonna be $100. Get on in. Listen here. I'm gonna give you these $100, but I'm gonna talk about Christ with you. Watch this. I did that 4 or 5 times when I was in Birmingham. I got 3 of them. 2 of them didn't listen, but they got that money. See, a lot of y'all ain't willing to do what it takes. That's why you ain't got what I got. Because you never know what method I use to win somebody. Because I see from the spirit of a who person is, not the flesh of which they doing. Huh? To the weak became I as weak, that I might gain the weak. I made all things to all men, that I might by all means save some. And this I do for the gospel's sake, that I might be partaker thereof with you. Know you not that was running a race, run all, but one received the prize. So run that you may obtain. Brother Hubbard get weak. But watch this. If I happen to fall in my weakened state, when I get up, you're going to hear this gospel. I don't care how much pipe I done laid to you. You're going to get this gospel. Huh? Watch this. Y'all remember how I told you? See, God prepares me for saying for anything. You remember how I used to tell y'all when I was first starting ministry and I was still out there and I used to sleep with a few women in town we get through. They want to talk about the Bible and I used to get all. You get what I'm saying? Why they want to talk about God? Because it was already in me. So the things they were asked are things I already have knowledge of, so I had to say it anyway. So the reason a lot of y'all like to condemn, convict, and judge others is because you ain't running your race because you too busy condemning my race and form. Oh, he talking about this, but he done slept with some women. You know, he cheated on his wife. Oh, he slept with that person. He slept. You don't know what I did. Because watch this. Like I used to tell my first wife this, because people used to come at her with all kind of assumptions. I can't help if I look good. You know, it just is what it is. I used to tell her, I don't want to hear sugar, honey, iced tea, what you got to say. If you don't touch me on my shoulder and say I got you, it wasn't me. It ain't me. Because see, people are say anything because they have to say anything because when they do wrong, it gives them comfort in what they doing. Around here trying to go in people's phones and in their laptops and all this and all that. What the hell you looking for? Y'all got to watch people like that. And every man that striveth for the mastery is temperament in all things. Now they do it to attain a corruptible crown, but we are incorruptible. I therefore so run not as uncertainly, so I fight as not as one that be there. But I keep under my body and bring it into subjection, lest that by any means what I have preached to other, I myself should be a castaway. Listen here. If I happen to mess up, y'all done already heard about it. You just don't even know. I preach my own faults. You just don't know when to preach it, when I preach them. But guess what? In preaching them, a lot of people get delivered. I don't need people to the so-called keep receipts on me. I got, for every receipt that somebody got of me that I messed up, I got a receipt of me preaching the truth of when I messed up, but delivering the people that's in the same thing I am. Guess what? Because Uriel, he keeps a thorough account of whatever I do. If you don't know who Uriel is, that means you ain't got a relationship with God. I was laying down in the hotel room the other night, and Laurel, he gave me that stern look. So I inboxed my buddy. I said, why are you around looking at me like this? Watch this. He knew who I was talking about. I said, he gave me a stern look. I said, I ain't never seen that look before, but I understood what it meant. Stay strong, buddy. Don't give up. Uriel is an angel. Uriel is the angel that guided Enoch when he walked. What a old girl and her husband that used to came down here from Michigan. I was doing a live video just like this. When I got through, she said it was a big old angel standing behind you. I said, I know it. He always behind me. He behind me now. Watch this. That's how I know. Now y'all hear when I say I know whatever going around me. He tell me going what around me. That's why when people try to lie to me, I don't say nothing. When people do something to me and lie on me, he keep a record of everything. So guess what? You can't judge me for no wrongdoing because I already been judged. And when I've been judged, I can't get judged twice for the same crime. So watch this. I got to run. I got a few things to do. Y'all be blessed and have a good day, I suppose.